For our third scenario, we'll see how we can have full manual control over the key for both the core mat and the edge mat. In most cases, you should be able to create a good key with any of the methods we've already covered, but this method does give you the most control. To start, click the hooked arrow to reset the keyer effect. By the way, if you undo the reset and do it again, you can clearly see the difference between the fully automatic key and the one we just created. It looks like we were able to recover more hair detail than the automatic key. For our manual key, we'll use this automatic key with a strength parameter at 100% as our starting point. Switch to the mat view and open the color selection tools. Click the manual button for the graph mode. A few important notes about manual mode. First, you can only use it when the strength parameter is greater than 0. Also, the refine key and strength parameters are now disabled. But if you had created samples and adjusted the strength parameter before switching to manual mode, those adjustments would be incorporated into the chroma and luma settings. Finally, once you've switched to manual, it's not a good idea to switch back to the scrub boxes mode, as you can get unpredictable results. If you move the pointer over the inner graph in the chroma wheel, you'll see that you can now adjust the size of the inner graph, which adjusts the colors included in the core mat. It can be difficult to work with a graph since it's so small, so press the Z key and click a few times in the chroma wheel to zoom in. Then hold down the H key and drag to pan the wheel. Now try adjusting the inner graph, observing the results in the viewer. By making it smaller, you may be able to recover more hair detail. You may need to zoom in even closer to adjust it. To zoom out, press and hold the Z key and the Option key and click on the wheel several times, then press H and drag to center it. Try adjusting the outer graph as well. Finish by adjusting the chroma roll-off. On the luma graph, you can now adjust the top handles, which control the luminance range included for the core mat. Try adjusting them. Then adjust the bottom handles. And then the luma roll-off. Switch back to the composite view. Open the mat tools and tuck in the white point slider to add some more hair detail. Open spill suppression and tuck in the white slider to remove the white fringing. Open light wrap and add just a bit, adjusting intensity so that it doesn't affect the bottom of the shot. That looks good. To finish up, close the keyer effect, close the mask effect, show the Correction 1 color board, go to the exposure pane, and brighten up the shot to fit better with the background. Go to the color pane and give it a warmer tone. And perhaps go to saturation and boost the global value a bit. Return to the video inspector. Great work. Now for a real challenge. For our last example, we'll look at how to key out a white background instead of a green screen. Select the third clip and move the playhead to a frame where the woman's hair is flying. This is a video clip from iStockPhoto.com. Now, iStockPhoto.com has a large number of clips that are shot on a green screen, but it also has many clips shot on white like this one, which can present more of a challenge. In addition, since this clip has also been heavily compressed, you'll find that it's almost impossible to create a good key. But let's see how far we can get. Final Cut Pro 10 includes a Luma keyer in the same keying category that is designed specifically to remove the lighter or darker parts of an image. However, I find that the keyer effect can actually do a better job on this kind of shot, since it contains all the tools in the Luma keyer and a few more to boot. Apply the keyer effect. The automatic settings don't work so well this time. Set the strength to 0. In the viewer, hold down the Shift key and drag a box on the white background. The white is very even, so it doesn't really matter where you draw the box or how large it is, as long as it doesn't touch any part of the woman, or else she'll disappear along with the background. There's still a lot of white in her hair. Hold down the Command key and drag an edge sample across her hair, and then adjust it. That's better, but there's still a lot of white. You may find as you adjust it that the woman's forehead turns gray since it's becoming transparent. Switch to the matte view. Increase the fill hole slider slightly to make the inside of the matte white. Then increase the edge distance slider all the way to get the detail back into the hair. Skim the clip. You may still see her teeth or her earring. Remember, we're keying out the brightest parts of the image, so her bright teeth and jewelry are getting keyed out as well. You aren't going to be able to fix those areas with the fill holes parameter, so let's hold off on that for now. Switch back to the composite view. In the color selection tools, you can try adjusting the lumograph by dragging on the curve or on the lower handle. But using the edge sample in the viewer is more intuitive and does the same thing. Notice how the lumograph changes as you adjust it. One thing the edge sample does not affect, however, is the luma roll-off, so you can try adjusting that. But there's still a lot of white fringing around the hair. Close the color selection tools and open the matte tools. Set Shrink Expand to about -5 to shrink the matte. Then set Soften to about 1 and try a few different values for Erode. These settings introduce transparency to her hair, but at least they eliminate the white fringing. Close the matte tools. Spill suppression won't help here with the white background, so let's skip it and open Light Wrap. Set the amount to about 4. Okay, now switch to the matte view and skim the clip. You'll see by the black areas that we have all kinds of transparency we need to deal with. We'll attempt to create a holdout matte, a smaller all-white matte inside the main matte. Switch back to the composite view. Press the up arrow to move the playhead to the start of the clip. Press Command-C to copy, then press Option-V to paste as a connected clip. Select the connected clip, and in the inspector, increase fill holes to 10. And set the edge distance to 0 to create a solid white mat. Now, we need the mat to be smaller, so it's always inside the mat on the lower clip. In the Matte tools, set Shrink Expand to -40. The slider won't go that far, so you either need to drag in the value field or type the value in. Set Soften to 10 and Erode to 10. If you skim the clip, you should now have a soft white blob, meaning that everything inside it should be fully opaque now. Switch to the composite view. Skim the clip. It's far from perfect, but we've managed to remove most of the white fringing and keep the core mat solid. Not bad for such a heavily compressed clip on a white background. To really make this key work, we'd need to keyframe the various parameters on almost a frame-by-frame basis. Okay, excellent work. I hope that by working through this appendix lesson, that you now have a good grasp on the advanced keying tools available in Final Cut Pro 10.